السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الله سبحانه وتعالى ordered the believers to do good to the parents. وقضى ربك ألا تعبدوا إلا إياه وبالوالدين إحسانا. Right after ordering the believers to worship none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, which is the most important thing, the purpose of our life, then after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا, and do good to the parents. And إِحْسَانًا is all types of goodness, that something that cannot be contained in one sentence. It's every good speech, is every good action. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the slightest discomfort that a person would be the reason for towards his parents is a major sin, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it in the Quran. وَلَا تَقُلْ لَهُمَا أُفٍّ وَلَا تَنْهَرُهُمَا. Do not say uff. Uff is not a word, it's just a gesture that shows the person is uncomfortable. This is a major sin. And therefore, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave that order and the verses were revealed, the Prophet ﷺ, the companions radiallahu anhum, they submitted themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They knew that this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants them to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by being so righteous and so kind, and to do the best they can when it comes to the parents, especially the mother. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, when a man came to him and this man had did a very evil crime, he killed someone, and he was asking a specific question about repentance. Would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept his repentance? And the crime was so evil. But the answer of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the cousin of the Prophet ﷺ, shows his fiqh, his knowledge, his understanding. And he asked him, do you have a mother? And he said, yes. And or in the narration said that he didn't have a mother. But then when he left, the people asked him, why did you ask him if he have a mother? He said a statement that I do not know an act that is more righteous, that would be sufficient for the repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, than to be kind to the mother. Something that is so great in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that it expiates the sins, that a person would enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of this kindness to his parents. And that's why it's an act of worship, it's an act of obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one important thing I want to mention, those who are righteous to their parents, it is not in disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If a person disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of his parents, this person is doing evil to his parents. Why? Because he makes the parents a reason for that person to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But rather, a person should be righteous to his parents, seek rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by doing so, by sacrificing, by doing the best he can to please their parents and not to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.